Hi everyone, I'm Audrey Macduff and I'm the network coordinator at the Empire State Pride Agenda. The network is a 20-year-old resource that continues to help nonprofit organizations in New York State, and I am hopeful that other states can follow in our footsteps. Today I'll introduce everyone to the network, as well as something we call the initiative. The network is the oldest and largest program of the Empire State Pride Agenda. It's a coalition of over 50 LGBT-specific and supportive organizations throughout New York State. The network was founded with the main goal of advocating for non-HIV and AIDS-related health and human service funding, since at the time that was the only money that was available to LGBT organizations. Not only does the network work tirelessly to advocate for new funding streams and to maintain the ones we have, but it is a way for organizations to share resources and best practices. While the network has dedicated staff at the Pride Agenda, the majority of decisions and organizing stem from collaboration amongst network members. My job is to oversee the day-to-day operation of the network, aka conduct a lot of conference calls, and I am supported by our director of programs. The network also prides itself in gathering a lot of data, and that is done with the help of an incredible research team, Strength in Numbers Consulting Group. As previously mentioned, we do a lot of conference calls. In order to best support organizations, we have work plan teams and committees that meet on a regular basis via phone. Our work plan teams focus on capacity building, cultural competency, funding advocacy, and membership. Additionally, our committees focus on issues that network organizations express interest in, such as healthcare, transgender rights, and youth programming. So here's the complicated part. The network is a project of the Pride Agenda, but it operates through funding by the LGBT Health and Human Services Initiative at the AIDS Institute of the New York State Department of Health. It's a really long title, and it's equally as confusing. Many, but not all, network organizations are funded by this initiative that gives that non-HIV and AIDS money to LGBT programs. I've only been the network coordinator for about a year now, and before that, I was a member in an organization for 3. But my predecessors did a great deal of work to change the climate for funding for LGBT organizations in New York State. The network started in 1994 with approximately 16 members and has grown year by year. Our first round of funding came in 1997, and in 1998, the first RFA for our initiative was released. As one would expect, our funding has ebbed and flowed and faced its share of struggles in the state government. Many folks think of New York as being solely progressive, but it's actually a very challenging political climate. The advocacy efforts that the network does do not come easy. Today, funding for the LGBT Health and Human Services Initiative stands at $5.26 million. It sounds like a lot, but it's not nearly enough to meet the diverse needs of LGBTQ New Yorkers. Network organizations serve in all 62 counties of New York State, but as you'll see on this map, many of the rural parts of New York State do not have adequate access to services. Serving rural New York has unique challenges, especially with so much funding being conducted and given to New York City. However, our network organizations are maximizing their minimal resources to offer that crucial programming and serve communities. What's next? Of course, we are going to continue our advocacy efforts and work to get organizations less reliant on singular funding streams. Additionally, we are working to expand individual and organizational understandings of the real health and human service needs of LGBTQ New Yorkers. We are currently in the process of conducting a statewide needs assessment with transgender and youth-specific modules. We know that our legislators love numbers, so this data is crucial for our advocacy efforts. Member organizations have said that the network is a way for them to connect and learn from people who are focusing on the same overarching goals. These efforts are not easy, our model is not perfect, but we know very well that nothing in this movement comes easy. I am confident that other states can create networks of their own and amplify the reach that LGBT organizations have in their home state. Thank you.